Maybe it's just me. Back in the pool. You know, I don't date much. I say it's because I work all the time, which is true in its way, but it also covers for the fact that I'm rarely asked out, and certainly not asked out twice. My friend Mandy has been giving me pointers.
You're not built for dating anymore. If you're going to survive this, you've got to practice feigning interest in uninteresting people.
She's right. I'm single for the first time since I was 19. The last time I was on the market, I was a twink. All I had to do was be cute and keep my mouth shut. This seems unfathomable to me now, but there is photographic evidence. I have two major issues with diving back into the dating pool. Thing one, when you're in a long relationship, you really get spoiled by the idea of the world at large not having seen you naked. It's hard to go back to the idea of running into people at Starbucks who could pick your dick out of a lineup. Thing two, you forget that everybody out there, including you, is a total freak in some way or another. You've just grown so accustomed to one person's freakiness that they seem normal to you and you to them. And then there are the unexpected details that really throw you for a loop. A few months ago, I had one of those nice moments in a bookstore where you're looking at a book and someone else is looking at a book, and then you talk about your respective books, and then you talk about books in general, and somehow that leads to talking about your favorite kinds of cheese or something, and then you've got a date for Friday. You go on the date, get along okay, maybe no great romance potential, but there's always room in your life for a new friend, and then you're talking about funny jobs you've had, and he mentions he has a side career doing bareback porn. Maybe it's just me, but that's kind of a deal breaker. I won't go into my lengthy opinions about bareback porn except to say it would be very difficult for me with my nasal, ironic voice to ever make reference to it without a trace of judgment. Just not gonna happen. Then the other night, the ex called.
Hey Topher. Listen, I locked myself out of the apartment. Do you still have your keys?
Yeah, come on over.
This is awkward. I'm kind of on a date.
Oh, well, it's fine. Really. I'll bring the keys down to you.
Thanks.
A few minutes later, I met him in the driveway with the keys, and I was introduced to his date. It was Mr. Bareback Porn. Okay, what would you do in this scenario? The ex is open enough to present me with his current suitor, and here I am knowing said suitor's average workday ends with a money shot.
Thanks, Toph.
Oh, look at that. I brought the wrong keys. Tell you what, come up and I'll get the right ones.
Okay.
I got the ex back upstairs alone in my apartment and went straight for my computer.
Topher, what are you doing? I'm kind of in the middle of something.
I know. Just wait. I need you to see a website.
Right now?
Yes, right now. Just hold on. Okay. Come look at this.
Is that who I think?
Yes, it is.
But how did you know
because
about...
Because he told me. When I went out with him. Once.
I gotta go.
And he left. Maybe I could have handled it differently with the ex, but time was of the essence here. And maybe it was unfair to Mr. Porn, he might have wanted to break it to him gently, but despite our recent history, if the tables were turned, I would want the ex to tell me. And he would. Hours later, after the ex had suddenly remembered he had an early day tomorrow and cut his evening short, we were on the phone for the first time in months, sharing our newfound common ground. That's the worst part about finding yourself suddenly single. The one person who can really relate to what you're experiencing is the person you're trying very hard to avoid. And then, without warning, you both date the same sex merchant and you're laughing and chatting like old times. And you know, in a way, that's kind of encouraging. Because if the ex and I are once again on speaking terms, maybe we did this the right way. Maybe I do attract decent guys, even if it doesn't last forever. And if I ever manage to start dating again, perhaps I'll have learned some sort of valuable lesson or something to make the next relationship even better. Isn't that how this works?